Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're going to take a look at a very interesting knife that is not well known by a lot of people but still in very high demand. We're talking about a collaboration by Richard Rogers and Best Tech to build an OEM version of his very popular slim utility model, and it looks like this. So this is the OEM slim utility. I will be just referring to it as the slim during this video to shorten it a little bit, and it's actually made by Best Tech and was released, I believe, during the beginning of 2021, but I really didn't know about it till about 3 or 4 months ago, just because the release of this knife really went a bit under the radar from what I could tell, and that's also why I'm doing the video. There is not a lot of content out there about this folder, and it still has a great demand and is in quite low supply. And I really hope that Richard Rogers is building some new runs of these. There have been quite a bit of different versions available of this folder, different anodizing pieces. There also has been one in carbon fiber, and there were ones with washers, as we have here, but most of them featured a ball bearing system. The blade finish and steel were always the same, as I think, always M390 with this media blast or bead blast finish. And all of them have been made by Best Tech. So very interesting new route that Richard Rogers is going here with this OEM build, because, you know, if you want to get a custom Rogers, you're spending upwards of multiple thousands of dollars depending on the materials. There are a bunch of different models that you can choose from, of course, but this is one of his most iconic designs, the slim utility. And of course, there were some other models available as well that you could get for quite a bit less money, but they were, of course, collaborations with production companies like CRKT. CRKT actually has released quite a bit of Rogers models, and this is probably the favorite that they have done so far. This is the Cinco, a knife that I also have reviewed on the channel, and this features the 2 G10 and the stainless steel frame or liner lock here, which is still a great option to get into a Rogers design and experience what makes his knife very interesting, but it certainly leaves you a little bit wanting for some higher end things, and those were not really available up until the release of the OEM slot. And so I think this really covers a nice niche between the high-end full custom knives that a lot of people just cannot afford, and they're also extremely hard to get because you just can build so few, and the lower-end mass-produced CRKT iterations, which are nice to get a taste of the Richard Rogers design language and features, but leave a lot of people that are into knife collecting a bit wanting for some higher end materials. And here we have like the Goldilocks area, where we have a price that is affordable for most people, because these released around 250 or 300 US at the time. Now, with the aftermarket doing its thing, they're going up to around 500 or even more. But they are still quite a bit more affordable than a real Richard Rogers custom. I don't encourage you to buy this at almost double what it originally went for, but it certainly is a great knife, and I certainly will show you that here during this video. So first off, let's take a look at the specs of this small slim utility folder by Richard Rogers and Best Tech. We have an overall length of 6.625 inches or 16.8 centimeters with a blade length of 2.75 inches or 7 centimeters. The steel is M390 and the blade stock is on the thinner side, I would say, at 2.75 millimeters. I don't have a caliper, so I can't really say for sure. If somebody knows, please put it in the comments below. And then we get a handle length of 3.875 inches or 9.8 centimeters and a very lightweight weight here at around 59 grams or 2.08 ounces. So just 2 ounces for a 2.75 inch blade with a full titanium construction is certainly a nice achievement, and they could do that by incorporating some very nice skeletonizing on the show as well as the Loctite scale. I will show you that here. We have a nice large pocket milled out right there, and on the lock bar side we also have a large pocket milled out, so very nicely done here on the weight savings department. And of course, with the thinner blade stock, you're also going to save some weight. Price-wise, as I said before, originally around 250 to 300. Now with the aftermarket, you can see almost double that. And it's always your prerogative how much you want to overspend, but I usually won't recommend to overspend on a knife, even if it's in low availability and high demand. There is a reason why a price was set for these knives at the original selling point. So in the end, if you overspend, you probably will be disappointed. Overspending a tiny bit, I can see that, but that is certainly always a thing that you have to decide for yourself. Regarding the knife itself, we have a great construction, I have to say. We have this very, very nice milling pattern that Bestech has executed extremely well. It is very nice to the touch, provides a bit of grip, and a ton of visual appeal. Really nicely done milling there. We have titanium hardware all around here. On this particular model, it is anodized in this like steel blue, together with the back spacer, the pocket clip screws, and this inside line of the pocket clip has worn away a bit. And then we get a titanium inset liner lock that also has a very nice milling pattern on it and is easy to get to. And here my particular version runs on some thick phosphor bronze washers, but most of the slims actually have been on a ceramic bearing pivot system. So a lot of different versions have been available, some green anodized ones, some blurple anodized ones, some full gray ones. So if you Google, you can see a lot of different versions of this folder, and there was also a full carbon fiber one available, if I'm not mistaken. On the blade itself, we get M390 with this bead blasted finish. I believe all of the models have featured M390 for the steel. And then we get this slim typical opening slot, also with some very nice milling in there and really well executed. So this opening slot enables you to open this blade in a lot of different ways. Of course, spidey flicking it works perfectly well. You can also thumb flick it. Of course, you can do it with the left hand as well, because it's ambidextrous. In that way, it also hasn't any occlusion to the opening slot. You can also spidey flick it with the left hand. And of course, you can also do a two-handed opening here as well. It's extremely smooth, especially for being on washers here on this particular model. Of course, you can also do it slowly and controlled if you like to do that. Forgot that before. But this slot is a real, real winner here on this knife. It makes it look very, very unthreatening, very people-friendly, and it's just an absolute breeze to manipulate. It's something different. It's not a flipper, not a thumb slip, not a hole, but it has all the benefits of being a hole while still looking quite a bit different and modern. So I really like the opening slot, especially the way that they have executed here. We get about mid-size or a bit higher starting flat grind on a thin overall blade stock in this nice reverse tanto or sheep's foot blade shape with some good belly, a nice and thin tip in front to do some utility cuts, and a nicely ground and thin blade there, nicely cleared plunge grind, sharpening choil, so the blade is very nicely executed. In terms of blade finish, I certainly would love to see something different, a stone wash, a satin finish, anything like that, maybe a two-tone. Not the biggest fan of this monochrome bead blast finish, but at the price point and with everything else that I have done here on this folder, I can see why they went with a very simplistic blade finish here. And I believe lots of the original slim utility folders also featured a finish like this, so maybe it's a nod to that. Also really liking the swedge at the top, makes it much more aggressive, much more modern, and just ties everything together really well. Great thing here is that you also have titanium hardware, nice and large torque screws, only 3 screws needed to hold this knife together. Nice external stop pin right there, and then we have the pocket clip. The pocket clip here is very nicely done. Also a great thing is that you get additional screws, shorter screws, so you can actually take off the pocket clip as well as these two standoffs and screw in these screws and then carry it with your included ledger carrying slip. So if you're a left-handed user, you cannot swap the clip, but you actually can take it off and use it as a loose carry in your pocket with the provided things. So that's a nice piece of versatility that they add into the box there. The clip itself is nice and springy, has some good clearance here, runs on this not too aggressive titanium milling, and is great to get in and out of the pocket with all of the different pockets that I tested it on. So very nice pocket clip. And size-wise, of course, this is a smaller folder. You know, I have 7.5 sterile glove, small to medium hands, and for me, it fits all my four fingers. For larger hands, this could be a three-finger folder, but for me, it's a great size. It's probably the smallest you could go without being too small, but you actually get a good amount of cutting edge, a very capable blade with a thin blade stock, a nice slicer, and that all collapses to a very easy to carry, extremely lightweight and very slim utility folder, and it certainly makes its name very true here with all the aspects that it implements. Fit and finish is done very well, perfectly centered, absolutely no play in any direction, feels very solid even though it's a nice and lightweight folder. Here you can see the lockup on the titanium liner. Access to the liner is very nice and easy to disengage with that very well executed milling on the lock bar there. And it just looks very good in the open as well as in the closed position. The whole form is closed, nothing is sticking up, no exposed tang or anything. Really well done. Another thing that they have done very well is the backspacer here. So you get just this little loop around portion of your backspacer that incorporates this quite large lanyard hole for the size of the knife, but it doesn't really take away from the overall design in my opinion. And on the inside, it's not protected. So it's just this loop around thing that the backspacer creates, and that makes it really well executed in my opinion. It's an ingenious way to do that without using a lot of titanium, adding something that sticks out from the frame. Really well done minimalist design here. Now let's do some other size comparisons that you do here on the channel. So we have our Shirogorov sandwich. We will show you that this is going to be quite a bit smaller than any of these Shiros. So F95 and L at the top and Neon Zero at the bottom. And you can see this is certainly a compact folder. Then we have the Benchmark EDC blades. We have the full-sized Bug Out, and we have the Spyderco Para 3, and you can see it's smaller than both, but in terms of overall footprint, certainly quite a bit closer to a Benchmade Bug Out. I believe this is quite close to a mini Bug Out, but in terms of cutting edge, you can see you get quite a bit for the small overall form factor that the Slim is actually representing here. Also, you will see that when you compare it to a Para 3, pretty much the same overall cutting edge with a much, much smaller handle, as well as with a very much easier to swallow footprint in the pocket. So that's very well done. Then some other comparisons we have here. I can show you the Thinco from before, which is going to be a bit larger, and some other smaller thumb stud opener. We have the Berg Blades Pop, and with a hole opening, we have the Quiet Carry Drift, also very close in the actual cutting edge. And then we also have the Olemic Cutlery Whippersnapper as a comparison. So it's certainly on the smaller side of EDC knives. For me personally, in an urban environment or for a gentleman's carry, this can certainly function as a primary carry. For some people, this also might be a great backup folder, just because it's super lightweight and it still has quite a bit of functionality to it, as its name suggests. So overall, I'm very, very happy with this knife. I think it's a great OEM work here from Richard Rogers and Bestech, and I hope that they bring out some more designs from Richard Rogers, like for example the Thinco, in this overall collaboration, because I would absolutely jump on this And I think if you can get this Slim at a reasonable price on the secondary market, I would absolutely jump on it. This is probably in its size one of the best knives you can get. The action is great, the fit and finish is nice. The design by Richard Rogers is absolutely proven and tested. The clip works great. It's super lightweight. And if you're looking for a super lightweight EDC piece in the city, in the office, or a gentleman's carry, this is certainly one you should take a look at. It's certainly a design that will not disappoint. And Best Tech did a great job on executing this. And Richard Rogers really chose a great OEM to bring this knife to more people than his customs. So this was my review of the Richard Rogers OEM Slim. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, put them down in the comment section below. Don't forget to click the bell icon to get notified whenever I release a new video, and follow me on Instagram at 7ready_knife_reviews. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.